See Lindelof videos, AP calculus, area of region between graphs. And this is what we're given. We're given y is equal to x squared, y is equal to negative x, and we're asked to evaluate that area from x is 0 to x is 2. So this is all I did. This is would not be on a calculator section, so I just sketched this graph myself. So this is what I have. I have that this is x squared, this is negative x, and this is the line x is equal to 2. Well, in this case, this is not a very difficult thing, is it? And the reason it's not a very difficult thing is this. On the whole interval, this function right here is on top of the other one. And we're going to see soon, when we look at this in a different way, that that's not always true. But if we look from 0 to 2, the x squared function is on top of the other one. That makes it really easy for us, because what we want is, we want the definite integral, in this case from 0 to 2, because that's what they define this as, of function on top minus function on bottom. So function on top is x squared, isn't it? Minus the function on the bottom. The function on the bottom, that would be this, right? It's over what function? And the function we can see, hopefully, that it's over is this function right here, that this is over that the whole way. And this function is negative x. So minus negative x dx. Because we want to subtract the area of the lower function. So I can see clearly that this is going to go to positive, but I want you to see how I got there. It's just this, isn't it? And then from here, we just have to, if this is on the exam, they're going to add, this is so easy that they're going to make you integrate this. So you're going to have to integrate. So when you integrate this, you're going to integrate this and then use fundamental theorem of calculus, right? So if I integrate this, I'm going to get x cubed over 3 plus x squared over 2 as evaluated from 0 to 2. You can put parentheses on the outside if you want. It doesn't matter, but they want to see this evaluation sign. So I'm going to evaluate that. And what this is suggestive of is that you're going to take f of 2 minus f of 0. Well, f of 2, I'm just going to plug this in, 2 to the third power is 8, so that's 8 thirds. So 8 thirds. 2 squared is 4. 4 over 2 is 2. I'm going to go ahead and do this in a different way so I can add these together. 2 is the same as 6 thirds, isn't it? So there's my 6 thirds. Hopefully you can see why. And then this negative sign is this one. But if you look carefully, f of 0, 0 cubed, 0 squared up here, is just 0. But I swear I would still write this for my AP reader. I do this bit of math, add 8 thirds plus 6 thirds, and get a total of 14 thirds. And this is an area question, so I would say it's the area. And I also would not use an approximation sign. I would use an equal sign. All right? So hopefully this is helpful. In the next video, I'm going to do the exact same question, but I'm going to do this question with a horizontal cross-section. So thanks for watching. If you have any questions or comments, please let me know. Oh, and if you haven't subscribed, please do.